hope you all enjoyed yourselves so far in a great setting amongst fabulous people within our sport. My wife told me to begin with I don't need to write a speech as I had verbal diarrhea. And I said that during the timeline, she told me unless I wrote it out, you guys would be getting set up and living in a fog, and you'd probably all be asleep. So why am I here? Well, 12 months ago, Sarah and myself filled a dream. And we're on best in show at the greatest dog show in the world, Crufts. And there's not a day since then that the amazing weekend doesn't run through my mind or is brought up by someone. In fact, two of those judges are in this room tonight, Mr. Ben Reynolds Frost and Jeff Corrish. Once again, thank you so much. Being briefed by the Kennel Club and others doesn't actually prepare yourself for the preceding days, weeks and months ahead. It has been a whirlwind from 6:30 the next morning when I was doing a Radio 5 live interview from the car park of this very hotel right through to this very exciting evening, none of which would I change or refuse to do if asked ever again. The pedigree dog show world has gone through some tough times in the last few years, and sometimes we haven't been quick enough to defend this wonderful sport. All of us in this room try our very best to produce happy, healthy examples of our pedigree breeds, spending many hours and many pounds in doing so. A vast amount of you in this room helped and participated in some way with Jilly's Jolly Jaunt last June, raising money for children and dogs charities. In that week, you all helped raise the profile of dog show people and proved to many that we are a dedicated bunch and a decent lot and don't deserve all the negative publicity we sometimes get. Nobody, including me, could have imagined that week walking would raise just under £50,000. It was simply staggering. So now is your chance to keep the doubters and sceptics quiet by continuing the goodwill we all know we are capable of. Welcome to the Peekaboo Trust.
Absolutely, yeah. This is the sort of culmination of all the hard work that everybody put into Jilly's Jolly Jaunt, and we're here today to give the money to the three charities. So, really proud moment.
And quite a staggering amount of support you've got, both financially and otherwise, from the whole dog community.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. I mean, we could never have foreseen how well everything was going to go and how much interest it got worldwide. So the grand total is £49,000, wow. Which wow. is brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. Dog Lost are getting just over 17,000.
Fantastic.
And Great Ormond Street are getting just over 29,000.
Wow.
And the Charitable Trust, Kennel Club Charitable Trust, are getting just under 2,500. So, really, really good. And I know for a fact that it'll be put to good use.
Yeah.
What does that sort of donation mean to the hospital?
So as a hospital, we rely on the generous donations of the public to ensure that we can continue to treat and to care for some of the smallest and sickest children in the UK. And each year we see 200,000 patient visits. And a donation of that size is phenomenal. And it's worth remembering that every single penny of that has been donated by members of the public. It's fantastic.
We've just had a tour around Great Ormond Street Hospital. And it was quite emotional. You knew what the money was going towards, but after seeing the struggle that families go through, how do you feel now?
It's amazing, really, to see. I don't think we realise the scale of this place. I think we know it's big, but you have no idea, really, of the amount of people that are here and the amount of work that really goes into it. And so it's amazing to be able to see where it's actually going.
And Gavin, being a father yourself, that must have been tough wandering through those wards.
Yeah, it's actually quite emotional, to be honest. You know, you don't realise, well, it makes you more grateful and thankful. You know, I've got two happy, healthy kids at home, but I think probably more so the families that are dealing with their sick kids. You know, the kids have been well looked after, obviously, but it's the families and the siblings that they've got to deal with it on a daily basis. So they've shown us around and we've been in the chapel, which was just leaves a lump on your throat. It actually makes it so gratifying that we've raised that sort of money and you can see what's going to happen with it. We all know the hospital does, etc., but when you're here, you know, you think, oh my God, you know.
Humbling, isn't it?
Absolutely, yeah. A perfect sort of closure to the whole event.
I'd just like to thank Amelia Siddle, who sadly can't be here tonight, for helping me so much in that walk. Without her, it would have been even tougher. So thank you, Amelia. The aim of the Trust is to raise money for children and dog charities by using the profile of people like you and the success you achieve to make a difference to those less fortunate than us. The visit to Great Ormond Street Hospital is something that will stick in my mind for many a year and an inspiration for helping to make a change. Tonight is a prime example where all the profits of the evening will go into this trust. The events may be small and local, but every penny will be distributed to worthy causes. Let's highlight the fact that high-profile breeds, coated breeds, and dogs of all shapes and sizes can do things for charity. And let's not forget the owners and breeders. Charity work can be done in any shape or form. Let's be honest, how much money could we raise by tying Ken Sinclair up and throwing custard tarts at him? The tying up bit he may actually like. If anyone has ideas or wishes to do a charity event for the Peekaboo Trust, then they will be all accepted and appreciated. You can help make a difference, no matter how big or small the event is. Every penny will count. Let's show the public how good we can be. We're all in a sport which we have goals and ambitions on different levels. Life is too short to fall over a pretty ribbon. But we can prove to everyone we try our best and are prepared to give something back to those less fortunate than ourselves. I fulfilled a boyhood dream last year, and on Sunday night, it will be someone else who can live the dream. However, none of this would have been possible without friends like you, an amazing wife and children. They put up with hours of me planning or doing something like this and the jaunt. So enjoy the rest of the evening, everybody. And every penny we raise tonight will go to a good trust. Thank you.
Supporting his work, and let's hope it can go from here and make even better things in the future.